What is up, everybody? My name is Isaac, the host of All Things Podcast, All Things Live, and the filmmaker behind all New Holland Films projects, also known as All Things Film. I'm the founder of my multimedia company, AT Multimedia, also known as All Things Multimedia, and I'm so stoked to be starting up my new channel today, All Things Star Wars. I'm so stoked to get this channel underway. There'll be lots of content coming from this channel as Star Wars Celebrations is just around the corner. Kenobi series is just a few weeks away. And today we'll be talking about the rumors and leaks of Kevin Feige's Star Wars movie. If you don't know who he is, he's the current president of Marvel Studios. We all barely know anything about Kevin Feige's Star Wars project, but here is some information that has been released that may happen, like some theories. I've read over it, and people are saying, their statement saying, it could be 100 years after Rise of Skywalker, or 100 years before The Phantom Menace. In my opinion, I would love to see 100 years after 100 years before Phantom Menace, but seeing 100 years after Rise of Skywalker could be cool. And now hear me out, Grogu, Baby Yoda Grogu, he'd be 300 to 400 years old then. I don't know, like 300 years old, I guess. He's 50 now, Mandalorian, about 300 to 400 years old. And he could be a Jedi Mandalorian. We could see Grogu grown up about 400 years old in his prime as a Mandalorian Jedi. How sick would that be? So here it says, when Disney announced a decade ago its plans to release one Star Wars film a year, starting with 2015's Star Wars The Force Awakens, the studio likely didn't factor all 3 years after the end of the sequel trilogy into its plans. But almost 3 years since the release of 2019's The Rise of Skywalker, the state of the film franchise is just up in the air. While Star Wars has continued to thrive on Disney Plus during that time, it's unclear when the saga will actually return to the big screen. I just honestly want to go back for a Star Wars movie. I don't care what Star Wars movie. I just want to go back, get all the hype around Star Wars again, and just go see Star Wars at the movies again. Yeah, we need another film. Rogue Squadron movie is currently being released in December 2023. I don't know if it's even happening. We don't even know if this show's cancelled. With Star Wars Celebrations this year, we are going to get a lot, and we're probably going to get a lot of information on the next Star Wars film, Star Wars shows. You know, they started filming the Ahsoka show a few days ago. Like, they started production. This is one important bit I was reading, or this. In recent years, Disney has shown interest in developing stories set hundreds of thousands of years before Luke Skywalker blew up the Death Star in A New Hope. The High Republic series, which will soon include a Disney Plus show called The Acolyte, is set 200 years before the events of The Phantom Menace. That's really what I want to see. I want to see The Acolyte. That would be sick. I want to see 200 years before The Phantom Menace. That's sick. That would be sick. No, none of the characters we have now. We'd see Yoda, obviously, in his prime. That would be sick. Okay. Meanwhile, rumors of Knights of the Old Republic movie set million before the Skywalker saga has persisted, with even Lucasfilm president Kathleen Kennedy, not a huge fan, giving my opinion, previously expressing interest in bringing that fan favorite era back to the big screen. So, it's most likely. See, The Acolyte is going to be a show. I want a movie. The Acolyte is going to be a show. But The Knights of the Old Republic, that could be a movie that Kevin may be doing. He's in the middle of writing it right now, as we speak. Knights of the Old Republic, that would be sick. But also, as I said, 100 years after Rise of Skywalker, Grogu as a Mandalorian Jedi, that would also be sick. Either one, I'll be happy with. I don't think it's going to be in, like, the Skywalker saga timeline, like, 1 to 9, or a couple of years after 9, or a couple of years before Phantom Menace. I don't think it will be in the Skywalker saga at all. I hope not. I want to see, not, like, 1 till 6, best Star Wars ever, 7 till 9, debatable, we can have a bloody 10-hour talk about that. But to see something before The Phantom Menace, that would be sick, like, hundreds, thousands of years ago, and then, like, 100 years after Rise of Skywalker, seeing that also with Grogu, because Grogu was obviously alive, there will be no Luke Skywalker, Rey will be dead by then, everybody, Finn, the Mandalorian, Din Djarin, he'll be dead, they'll all be dead, no Ahsoka, no, nobody, and it will be the next chapter of Star Wars, I guess. They could continue off with that, but heaps of movies, and Grogu becomes the next Yoda, very wise, everybody goes to him. I'd be down for that. Like, I don't know, the Knights of the Old Republic, I really want to see before The Phantom Menace, but after Grogu, man, he's an incredible character, and they got to develop him so much, and they will continue developing him, so that would be cool. 100 years after Rise of Skywalker, probably I want to see that more. And then, you know, we got The Acolyte, a show coming out, probably, like, 2020, late 2023, 2024, I don't know, they'll announce it all on Celebrations. I'll be covering all of that as well, so make sure you do subscribe, turn notifications on, because I'll be covering everything that happens at Star Wars Celebration, everything relevant. So, 100 years after, right, with Grogu being a Mandalorian Jedi, that would be sick. No, I really think so. You know, there'll be nobody, Luke's already dead, there'll be no Rey, no Ahsoka, there'll be no Din Djarin. They'll all be dead. It'll be Grogu by himself, you know, with young Padawans. Who knows? But I'm down. Basically, that's all for today. So that's, we still don't have much that could be happening. But Kevin, I hope you do good. I really do. I think you will be. I think you will. He's in the middle of writing at the moment. He stated that he's having a good time at the moment writing it. He's enjoying it. So, I mean, yeah, I can't wait. I hope we get the film soon. Obviously, he's in the middle of writing it. Everything will be announced at Celebrations, as I said. So, I'll cover all that when it comes. But, basically, that's all. And, yeah, thank you for watching the first video. It was incredible. And, yeah, it should be good. It should be good.